Assalamualaikum and good morning everyone. Welcome to ASTRO 2020 annual meeting on the innovation in the rate management. Today, me, my Sarah and my colleague Damia are representing our team to share our response plan management for the following situation. On the 21st January 2015, there were few staff from the vendor company entered the premise and attempt to remove the source assembly from the radiation head of the cesium-137 teletherapy unit. In the attempt, the source capsule was ruptured. The radioactive source was in the form of cesium chloride salt, which is highly soluble and readily dispersible. The source material glowed blue in the dark. The next morning, a staff found right-sized green scattered from the teletherapy unit to the back door of the department. There were also five staff in the department at the time before the first patient came.
What is cesium-137? Cesium-137 is highly radioactive material which is highly dispersible like talcum powder, soluble in water, and binds easily to surface like concrete. Cesium-137 is cesium chloride, so has a half-life of 30 years, meaning it will stay around for a long time and pose a serious danger if inappropriately handled. Although in medical, cesium-137 can be used in treating cancer in radiotherapy and used in small amount of calibration of radiation detection equipment such as gigamolar counters, exposure to large amount cesium-137 can cause burn, radiation sickness and increased risk of cancer, and in case of very large quantities, it's death. Looking back in half century, there have been several worldwide radiological accidents and incidents involving cesium-137. For example, Chernobyl disaster, Fukushima Daiichi disaster, Goiânia incident in Brazil, and so on. Those accidents had caused confirmed death and severe injuries due to the radiation contamination. In our response plan, it is divided into several management protocols as stated here. First, management for contaminated area. Second, for management for radiotherapy patient. Third, management for contaminated staff and patient. Fourth, for management for normal patient, staff and public. And fifth, management for source.
Firstly, management for contaminated area. In managing contaminated area, disposable personal protective equipment PPE such as caps, gown, glove and pocket dosimeter should be equipped by all staff. Then radiation dose monitoring is performed by using calibrated radiation meter to survey any potential contaminated area. The instrument parameter is set and the radiation probe is covered with a plastic. Any potential contaminated area is assessed at recommended 1 cm by moving instrument very slowly. Following that, radiation therapists will evacuate the suspected contaminated area promptly as possible to avoid further contamination on other patients. Decision on evacuation should be governed by the predetermined operational intervention level or guide based on observable condition at the scene. IAEA recommended a downwind evacuation for at least 100 meters. Evacuees should also be instructed not to smoke, eat, drink or place hand near mouth. Also to wash hand, shower and change clothes when possible to avoid inadvertent ingestion. Then radiation therapists need to inform Radiation Protection Officer RPO to confirm the spillage and supervise the decontamination and monitoring procedure. According to the Ministry of Health Malaysia MOH, if the area exceeds 5 microsievert per hour, decontamination should be timed. Lastly, radiation therapists should report the incident to MOH in the case of cesium-137, closing down the radiotherapy department or even hospital, depend on how large is the extent, might be put into action.
The second management is the management of the radiotherapy patient. We need to apologize and inform patient regarding the delay of the radiotherapy treatment. For the patient that have arrived, we will transfer them to other center for the treatment on the day where possible. In addition, we will also inform patient who have not arrived or not to come for treatment and reschedule their treatment as soon as possible. Referring to other hospital for the remaining treatment should be taken into consideration due to the closing down of the RT department, which might take months.
Proceed to the management for the contaminated staff and patient. RPO and RPS will measure the radiation level of the staff and patient. People with a low internal dose can be isolated at home and avoided contacting with a pregnant woman, breastfeeding woman and children. People who are contaminated with high internal dose, which is more than 100 mg per hour, will need to be isolated and decontaminated. An isolation zone is set up to isolate the staff and patient who suspected to be contaminated. In the condition of hospital close down, contaminated the people will be sent to other hospital for isolation. Then, a decontamination zone is also prepared to execute the decontamination process. In the contamination process, contaminated clothing and equipment on body were removed, and all were decontaminated by taking several baths with soap and water. For internal contamination with the radioactive cesium, a drop named Prussian Blue can be prescribed for them to promote the decomposition of cesium. It might reduce the risk of death and major illness from the radiation. Then, interview should be conducted to record the details regarding the radiation exposure from the staff and patient containing radionuclide and to determine all the people who have contacted. Human who contact with the cesium-137 might suffer from food poisoning, contact dermatitis of pemphigus, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, dizziness, and fatigue, radiation-induced skin injuries to different extent to hands, feet, leg, or other area of the body. Treatment will be given for those whose radiation sickness symptoms have arisen. Daily hematological medical examination as well as good nursing care will be contribute to the early detection and therapy of local systemic infection. Long-term follow-up is necessary. Psychological support should be given for all contaminated people by giving them education on possible radiation effect and radiation side effect management. Radiation therapists can reduce their anxiety and doubt by comforting them so they can always fight the disease with positivity.
Next is management of normal patients, staff and public. Dissemination of information to the communication media and the public should be carried out in order to alert public and put them in radiological and biologically controllable location. Since the hospital might experience close down, a temporary radiation monitoring center such as stadium or any open wide area or another hospital can be set up and used to radiation monitoring. Public who is suspected to have contact with the leaking source can go to the center to have a dose checkup.
Last but not least, the management of the source. Due to the transportation of the ruptured source assembly, the tracing of the source should be carried out immediately to control the spreading of the radioactive contamination. In the recovery of the leaked source, careful planning and setting up device such as pallet of the brick or a concrete block near the source should be done in order to protect the recovery workers.
To prevent this incident occur again, we have radiation emergency disaster rate preventive plan. First, radiation protection and radiation monitoring protocol. Radiation dose monitoring should be performed before and after installation and removal of the equipment that involving radiation. This is to ensure that all the areas are under radiological control and to not notice any possible radiation leakage. Second, standard operating procedure SOP for removing source from any radioactive machine. Ministry of Health, MOH Malaysia have issued and implemented the Standard Operating Procedure under Atomic Energy Licensing Act 1984 for radioactive material inventory management. All related personnel should abide by the rules and regulations during installation and removal of the radioactive material as well as handling the radioactive waste. Third, continuous education on radioactive source cesium-137 for staff and public. Campaign and seminar should be organized in order to raise staff and public about the danger of the radioactive source and the way to recognize and avoid contact to it. Lastly, training and continuous medical education for incident learning. CME for incident learning can be conducted when there is a radiation disaster occurred. Through this session, all RTT staff can learn on how to take action when a similar accident occurs again in the future. Whereas, training or drill for radiation emergency can also be conducted from time to time in order to train staff respond and get them familiar to the possible situation.
So, finally, here is our references. Thank you for listening.